I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. At this time, I ask you to remain standing for the singing of the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Good morning. First and foremost, I hope everyone joining us today and their families are safe and healthy. I'm Rob Montemurro, principal of Platt High School, and along with assistant principals Mr. Jeffrey Kenyon and Mr. Peter Civitello, I'd like to welcome you all to Orville H. Platt High School's Class of 2020 commencement ceremony. On behalf of the Platt administration, faculty, and staff, I'd like to welcome our esteemed Board of Education member, Vice President Mrs. Kim Carbone-Pandiani. In addition, our Central Office Administration, our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Mark Benigni, Assistant Superintendent for Technology and Operations, Mr. Michael Grove, and a Director of Student Supports and Special Education, Mrs. Patricia Sullivan-Kowalski, along with all the parents, grandparents, family, and friends to this special event that we celebrate this beautiful day. I'd like to start by thanking the parents and guardians of our students, but more so to our seniors who sit before you today for the courage and the fortitude you demonstrated during these unprecedented and challenging times. Whether embracing new ways of distance learning, interacting positively with students and teachers, or representing Platt High School in our classrooms and ball fields on both the local and state levels, our students were always the best ambassadors for our school and our community. As Platt High School's 2020 valedictorian, Haley Peacock, noted, "This is our time. We have spent the last 13 years of our lives preparing, and now we must stand, push forward, stay strong, and know that the future is in our hands." And from Alexis Williams, "My advice to my class is to take the time for yourselves. Break, learn, rebuild, heal, and grow, because as we grow, everything changes from thoughts to desires. Also, don't let anyone hold you back or derail you from your full potential. I love you all." And finally, from Rifat Hossein, who stated, "Nothing is impossible. If I can do it with English as my second language, then you can do it. Never give up." Your accomplishments this year are nothing short of remarkable, and all of us look forward to hearing about your continued successes on your next journey. Also, a special thank you to all the parents and guardians for raising such fine young students and entrusting them to us each and every day. Remember, seniors, we all have the power to succeed and challenge ourselves. Please find it within you and use that power. In the words of former President Barack Obama, Change will not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the change that we seek. To the class of 2020, you will always be Panthers for life.
Congratulations, graduates. Congratulations on everything you've achieved. You made it. I'd like to thank your family and friends for nurturing you and for instilling the importance of education. A special thank you to your teachers who have helped guide you along the way. I am most proud of the fact that you are accepting of differences today more than any generation before you. You understand how being in a diverse community enriches your life and those around you. Remember to keep your heart open. As you embark on this next chapter in your lives, know that how you treat others matters the most. Not how many likes you receive on social media or how popular you think you are. It is important to spread kindness along the way. Help your neighbor. Hold the door for a stranger. Let a car cut in front of you. Pay for someone's coffee. Listen to someone's story, even if you've heard it before. Be kind. That is what will define you. I applaud you and celebrate all that you are. Congratulations, Platt Panthers.
Thank you. Let me start by congratulating you, the Platt High School class of 2020. Success does not occur alone, so please take a moment to thank your families, teachers, and classmates. As I thought about the message I wanted to leave with you, the Orville H. Platt High School class of 2020, I reflected back to a book I read this past year. It is entitled, The Second Mountain, The Quest for a Moral Life, by New York Times best-selling author, David Brooks. He writes, "The people who make the wisest vocation decisions are the people who live their lives every day with their desires awake and alive. They are the ones who see their desires, confront their desires, and understand what they truly yearn for. So find what you yearn for and live your life with passion, persistence, and purpose. Even though you face challenging circumstances your senior year, you still have accomplished so much. Leave Platt High School with a sense of great pride and satisfaction. Use the education and experiences you have had in the Meriden Public Schools and right here at Platt High School to create your own pathway as you climb your mountain. Congratulations, Platt High School class of 2020. Your success and achievements validate that here all students succeed."
Please welcome the president of the class of 2020, Sydney Bernier.
If I'm being honest, when I sat down to write this speech, I was at a loss for words. How do you recap a senior year that got cut 4 months early? How do I confidently tell my fellow classmates to look forward to the future when our first steps into the real world are clouded by a pandemic? I'll tell you how, because we're Panthers. We were told from the moment we arrived, enjoy it while it lasts, high school goes by in a flash. But we were never told, say goodbye to your friends and teachers in March because a virus is going to come and take it all away. We didn't believe what we were told anyway. We laughed and thought high school would never end. 4 years felt like an eternity that we couldn't wait to be free of. Now I think I speak for everyone when I say I'd give anything to walk these halls again. Everything seems to have gone by in a blur. No longer are we kindergartners clinging to our parents' leg and begging them to take us back home with them. We're Panthers now, and we're ready to take the world by storm in whatever way we can in these unprecedented times. Many of us are probably still feeling a little bit like that scared kindergartner, afraid of what the future might hold, unsure of when we'll be able to hug our friends again, and desperately hoping we aren't meeting our college professors via computer screen in the fall. But I know that the support system we were given at Platt has prepared us to excel in any situation. To all Platt faculty, there are no words to adequately thank you for all that you did. You taught us all you knew, listened to us when no one else would, made your classroom a safe space, prepared for us for college, dealt with us when we were late, and shaped us into the people we are today. I wish I could shout out every single one of you for the greatness you have helped every student achieve. To our parents, you have done everything in your power to make sure we felt loved, supported, and understood in a time when nothing really made sense. And all you ask for in return is that we make you proud. I hope we have done that today. To my fellow students, I'm glad we could all collectively agree to forget middle school. It was an awkward phase for everyone. To my friends, thank you for understanding the struggles of being a teenager in high school. It certainly wasn't easy. To anyone I didn't get the pleasure to call my friend, never underestimate how impactful your presence can be, even to a total stranger. It's hard to talk about the great memories the class of 2020 made without wondering about all the memories we didn't get to make. I wonder who would have been prom queen, or who would have eaten until they puked at senior outing. And I wonder what it would have felt like to give this speech in a crowd of friends and family instead of to a camera. But we can't focus on what didn't happen, because then we'll forget all that did. Our win streak against Maloney and Powderpuff is now 4 years strong, and this year we decided to start a new streak of not even letting our crosstown rivals score. The drama department took home many trophies at the Connecticut Drama Festival and produced many stunning plays each year. The football team led us to victory and brought home the Stoddard Bowl trophy twice. We dominated the underclassmen in this year's pep rally relay race. Some memories we only got to make because of the special circumstances. Myself and another student created an Instagram account where we showcased all of our graduating classes' plans for the future. And who can forget when our parents surprised us by spelling "We love you, class of 20" on the fence surrounding the football field. And that's only the beginning of the memories and accomplishments our class is going to achieve. Though this year has been nothing like any other year we've seen before, this class has been like unlike any other class before them. We have shown perseverance in the way of adversity and community during a crisis that would otherwise keep us apart. We started our senior year excited for change, but scared to know what the future would hold. As the year progressed, we became even more unsure if our high school career was over before we knew it. Even now, giving this speech, I'm not sure what next year will look like, but I do know one thing. No matter what obstacles we are faced with, we have been given every tool to overcome it. For that, myself and the class of 2020 are forever grateful to our teachers, parents, friends, coaches, directors, and anyone else who helped us along the way. Class of 2020, remember this simple thing when you feel self-doubt. You did it. People may have doubted you, you may have doubted yourself, but you're here and you did it. Whether this day seemed like it would never come or like you would never get here, you did it. It doesn't matter how you got here or who had to help you, you're here. People often say high school would be the best years of your life, but I don't think that's true. I think about all the potential my classmates have and think, no way this can be it. Musician Eddie Vedder once said, "Let's say knowledge is a tree and it's growing up just like me." I know this chapter of our lives didn't exactly go as planned, but even the best plans sometimes go wrong. Each and every one of you are so unique in every way. You have so much to offer in this world, and I feel lucky enough to have gotten to experience just a small percentage of it. I wish nothing but success and happiness for every single one of you. You should be proud of how far you've come and have faith that you can go farther. Although this may feel like the end, high school graduation is only the beginning of the rest of your lives. Now I'll leave you with something I miss saying to you guys every morning on the announcements. Have a great day, Panthers.
Please welcome the salutatorian for the class of 2020, Anna E. Gutierrez.
Hello, class of 2020. Never would I have thought I'd be beginning a speech thanking all essential workers, but at times like this, it's evidently needed. So to all nurses, teachers at Platt High School, especially my influential teachers, Mrs. Gajecki, Mr. Corey, Mrs. Z, and many more, I thank you. I'd also like to thank my parents for supporting me all throughout my life and continuing to do so to this day. There are no parents better than you. Now to you, graduates of 2020. In the fall, we were referred to as the class with vision, but that quickly went away, and now we're viewed as the poor class who's had to deal with an unfortunate pandemic. However, don't consider this a step back. Picture an upgrade. I mean, at least our class has a special spot in the history books. 2019 who? Never has there been a class given the opportunity to display their knowledge and ability as fast as ours. It's our time. It's our time to demonstrate how essential we are by applying the importance of voting we learned in civics, the leadership skills we gained at Safety Patrol in fifth grade, and the discipline taught to us at John Berry, Hanover, wherever you attended elementary school, to rebuild our community, to shape a future that's not just ours, but our siblings, our children, and our grandchildren as well. Despite all odds, we have been able to unite during tragic events, such as the death of NBA star Kobe Bryant, the coronavirus, and the horrible deaths that leave minorities fearful of taking a jog. Horrible deaths that leave minorities fearful of being arrested without being murdered. And that'll happen just this year. Yet we still managed to graduate. And for that, I congratulate us. We're finally done dealing with AP testing, SAT testing, and worst of all, freshmen, even though we'll all be freshmen next year. But whatever. As we enter this foreign world of adulting, I leave you with one tip. Don't stick to the plan. Now is the time to throw out the master plan. Date a guy or three. Try out for the basketball team, debate team, drama club, why not? Allow yourself to be reborn. Muhammad Ali once said, if they can make penicillin out of moldy bread, they can sure make something out of you. So whether you're number one in your class or 220, make something of yourself. Life after high school isn't about college and school and more school. It's about challenging and forming yourself into the best possible version of you. Because only through this process of growth will your confidence, perseverance, and determination skyrocket you down that path specifically created for you. I'd like to conclude my speech by reminding all graduates of Platt High School to be proud of themselves today. We did it. We just completed high school. 3 years ago, the national dropout rate was 5.4%. Hey, at least that's not you. But seriously, graduating high school is a special milestone. So stay in and celebrate. And remember that not only have we accomplished this together, but we've done it while being literally apart. For that and all of your many successes, I congratulate you. Thank you.
Please welcome the valedictorian of the class of 2020, Haley Peacock.
So, this isn't where we thought we'd be. I thought I might even get out of giving a speech this year, but here we are. Despite the unfortunate circumstances, I still feel immense pride, joy, and hope when I look around at the class of 2020. I'd like to start by thanking everybody at Platt High School who has supported our class over the past 4 years. To our class officers and advisors who planned and organized our events, thank you. To our teachers who worked tirelessly to prepare us for this day, thank you. You have helped us make the most of these past 4 years. To our administrators who always had our backs, thank you. Finally, I'd like to thank my peers. It has become clear that without each other, our experience at Platt High School would have been very different. As peers, we've been through a great deal together. We've seen each other through the good and the bad, the ups and downs of high school. As Panthers, we've celebrated together. We've cheered together. As class...
Just start with that one sentence.
As Panthers, we've celebrated together and we've cheered together. We've rejoiced at the sound of yet another false fire drill during our least favorite class. As classmates, we've crammed together and we've stressed together. Nothing is more stressful than a chemistry test, if you know what I mean. But we did that together too. Though physically separated as a class, I know we've never been closer. I feel tremendous pride seeing how our senior class has banded together and at the strength we've shown. That being said, attending a half-built high school taught us how to navigate roadblocks pretty early on. All jokes aside, we have come together when it matters most, adapting in even these difficult circumstances. As someone wiser than I once said, dare to dream, but please also do. For dreamers are many and doers are few. As we move forward, we know now more than ever the impact that each and every single one of us can have going forward. However, it is not enough to simply know. We must also do. As the class of 2020, we are the newest additions to a global community. It is our turn to take our passion and dedication and use it to better our world. While it is important to dream, we must also see these dreams through to reality. That is how we will make an impact on our world. While many of us will make our mark sometime in the future, there are many members of our class that already have. To our classmates currently at work, as CNAs, as grocery workers, and other essential employees, we thank you. You push our community forward and are already the doers that we aspire to be. Although it may be hard to believe, we made it. Congratulations to each and every single member of the class of 2020. It is our time now. Thank you.
Before we award the class of 2020 their diplomas, I would like to tell you some facts about this class. This year, our graduates from Platt High School will be pursuing a variety of paths as they make their way out into the world. Many will be continuing their education at 2- and 4-year colleges, career technical schools, or a branch of the armed services. Others will begin apprenticeships or become productive members of the workforce. Our graduates will be attending colleges and universities such as Albertus Magnus College, Curry College, Johnson and Wales University, Marymount, Manhattan College, Quinnipiac University, Rochester Institute of Technology, Siena College, Springfield College, Stevens Institute of Technology, University of Alabama, University of Connecticut, University of Maine, University of Rhode Island, and Western New England University. Seniors planning to further their education have identified over 60 different potential majors, including biology, business, chemistry, computer science, criminal justice, education, engineering, graphic design, mortuary science, nursing, physical therapy, political science, psychology, and social work. To date, the class of 2020 has reported receiving commitments of over $2.3 million in grants and scholarships projected over the next 4 years. I am very proud of the accomplishments of this very talented class.
Esteemed Board of Education member, Vice President Mrs. Kim Carbone Pandiani, Superintendent Dr. Benigni, Assistant Superintendent Mr. Grove, and Director Mrs. Patricia Sullivan Kowalski, I would like to present to you the following students who I testify have met all the requirements as prescribed by the State of Connecticut and the Meriden Board of Education. I recommend the following members of the Orville Hitchcock Platt High School Class of 2020 for awarding of the diplomas. I would like to invite Assistant Principals Kenyon on stage with Mrs. Pandiani to assist in awarding of the diplomas. Fabiola Karina Acevedo. Brian Acosta. Ricardo Adorno. Kaylin Yamil Ayash. Michael Adu. Antonio Giovanni Alfano. Jose Wilson Alvarez. Aiden Michael Anino. Javier Aponte. Eric Arce. Mylesha Lamour Armour. Congratulations. Joshua Isaiah Arnold. Jonathan Michael Avitable. Natalia Isabella Badilla. Typhon Nikas Bagsi. Devin James McDonald Bell. Sean Antoine Bell Jr. What's up, bro? Manasia Bennett. Julia Andrea Lee Bessler. Cynthia M. Bond. Giovanni Alexis Bonilla. Emilio Manuel Barrero. Kyrief Tyson Brackett. Noah Patrick Bradley. Haley Jean Brooks. Greg Ricardo Burrell. Jose Caban. Christian David Calero Chalarca. Joshua Adam Campbell. Christian Caraballo. Jermaine Carter. Nayeli Castro. Megan Elizabeth Serby. Cody Dwayne Chambers. Ian Michael Chapman. Justin J. Charpentier. Jack Michael Clancy. Elizabeth Mildred Cleveland. Angelina Cole Catron. Jonah Concepcion. Lixagel Iris Cruz Vargas. Chase Anthony D'Angelo. Colin David Dandelski. Jalen Mackenzie Davis. Antoinette Abisha Dial. Javon Daniel DiCarlo. Robert David Duvall. Wes Harlan Dino. Juan Carlos Diaz. Marjorie Diaz. Yahim Joseph Dixon. Brandon Yang Donnery. Gabriel Darcy. Patrick Javon Doivan. Alfred Ducey. Gabriella Encarnacion. Allison Espinoza Hernandez. Luis Antonio Estramera Alicia. Angel Renee Evans. Terry Lee Evans. Miranda Lynn Fierney. Nurka Lee Feliciano Diaz. Carlos Ivan Ferment Rios. Kaiwana Damone Fields. Deja Marie Figueroa. Alexander Emmanuel Philippides. Caleb Alexander Bonafine Flom. Jibelis Nicole Flores Jimenez. Alexander Joseph Flynn. Cameron Philip Fox. Luke David Furstenberg. Nayeli Galvez Salazar. Kalia Rajan Gomez. Brittany Shanice Gonzalez. Angelia Ramona Gould. Yamelis Guadalupe. Jaylene Marie Guzman. Angel Lee C. Hart. Caitlin Teresa Rose Hart. Keziah Lena Haynes. Hey, how are you? Good. Sarah Ashley Henault. Heriberto Hernandez. Freddie Els Hidalgo. LaShawn Akea Hill. Amanda Lynn Hills. Rifat Hossein. Destiny Lynn Huff. Samantha Ann Izzo. Nadia Sarai James. Jocelyn Nicole Jaramillo. Anna Marie Jimenez. Jalen Ajani Lewis John. Anissa Mary Johnson. Indus Lam Cook. Patrick John Kudevich. Carla Ann LaFlamme. Natalia Dania Lancy. Ethan Talbot Latman. Markia Lewis. Alaya Marie Little. Said that wrong, didn't I? Jocelyn M. Latuma Chabla. Enzel Lopez.
That one hit harder when you say my name, huh?
Michael Lopez.
Gabriella, Alina, Luca. India, Eliz Makowitz. Tatiana J. Maldonado. Javon Cameron Malone. Melina Marie Mann. Felicity Martinez. Jackie Martinez. Kayla Elizabeth Martinez. Andrew Stephen John McCarty. Michael Keith McManus. Micaiah Eve Medina. Victoria Amaris Medina. Noelis Marielle Melanciano Murillo. Ariana Alaya Rosemary Mendez. Lizbeth Mendez. Madison Virginia Mendoza.
That's the one who wasn't going to come. Yeah.
Trayvon Ivory Mention.
You made it. Always, bro. Always, bro.
Melissa Madrano. Eduardo Mercado. Adam Paul Medica. Elijah John Monken. Damian Jeffrey Morales. Ariana Michelle Morales. Naisha Lucia Morales Torres. Jasmine Moran. Marquino Dwayne Morris.
Raja Mueller. Jasmina Elizabeth Mukanovich. Nicholas Joseph Muniz. Emily Nava. Giselle Negret Campos. Stephen Wade Nelson. Malachi Tyshawn Nesmith Ortiz. Aaron Michael Nieves. Lizbeth Nieves. Connor Charles Noel. Jose Daniel Nunez Jr. Jacob Cameron Nye. Courtney Jessica O'Brien. Molly Rose Olander. Edgar Ricardo Orellana Zelaya. Angelica Belen Orellana. Isaiah Ortiz. Alex Yadiel Ortiz Oyola. Adelina Jasmine Ortiz Perez. Angelica Judith Ortiz Perez. Cassandra Oslander. Derek Oyola. Eliani Yamaris Padilla Amesquita. Jocelyn Leela Yolanda Padilla. Aliana M. Pagan. Kyle Christopher Parmalee. Emily Perez. Isaac Daniel Perez. Joshua Lewis Perez. Alec Michael Perry. Brianna Marie Phillips. Elena Catherine Pierce. Savannah Natalia Pizarro Rodriguez. Thalia Marie Quillis. Christopher Arbeliz Quinones Hernandez. Enrique Raymond Quintana Maestra. Okay. Good. Francis Merritt Ramirez Brito. Alex Ricky Ramirez. Oriana Angelique Ramirez. Gabriella Ashanti Ramos. Jaden Anthony Ramos. Nicholas Palmer Woods Ramos. Haisha Crystal Reyes Yambo. Jeremiah Reyes. Grady Jr. Reynolds. Penelope Montserrat Riestra. Vanessa Paige Rios. Aracha Liz Rivera Oquendo. Annabelle Jeriel Rivera Roman. Aliana Rivera. Angel Rivera. Jael Julian Rivera. Lillian Marie Rivera. Tariana Rivera. Naomi Marie Robles. Bianca Rodriguez. Joshua Alexander Rodriguez. Lisbeth Anais Rodriguez. Valeria Nicole Rodriguez. Jada Rogas. Yasiel Rodriguez Roman. James Robert Rondini. Damian Rosa. Yep. Dante Rosa.
Congrats, bro.
Mark Anthony Rosado. Sebastian Anthony Rosario. Isaiah S. Ross. Jaden Matias Rojas. Wesley Michael Samples. Jonathan Silvani Santiago Flores. Kiana Marie Santiago. Did it. Najee Juani Santiago. Brandon Evan Segura. Marlon Antonio Serrano. Madison Elizabeth Singham. Teal Elizabeth Singleton. Anas Mustafa Scarab. Justin Mark Sloan. Pedro Rodolfo Solis. Kaylin Marie Spellacy. Chastity Strain. My Queen Chantel Streeter. Devin Jacob Tanner. Tyler Theron Tarducci. Joshua Andrew Thorne. Jade Maximus Torres. Leilani Mary Torres. Zachary B. Torres. Brandon Kyle Tran. William Traverso. Jordan Alexander Tuberville. Kevin Valentin. Brandon Lewis Vargas. Joseph Gabriel Vasquez Alicia. Gabriel Lewis Vasquez. Lewis Angel Vasquez. Jasmariah Mia Vega. Giselle Velasquez. Annalise Dalia Varela. Andrea Peyton Vitello. Mackenzie Florence Washington. Alexis Chanel Williams. Jason Woods. Jared David Watton. Elijah Daria Wright. Elijah Eugene Wright. And now, for the class officers of the class of 2020, Secretary Julio Daniel Hernandez. Treasurer Ashley Janice Bonilla. President of the class of 2020, President Sydney Bernier.
Congratulations. And now for the top 10 of the class of 2020. Number 10, Raina Maria Martinez. Number 9, Nicholas Joseph Martin. Congrats. Number 8, Isabella Rosina Martin. Number 7, Etta Nur Ahiskeoa. Number 6 for the class of 2020, Natasha Nori Sitar. Number 5, Elizabeth Ann Wozniak. Thank you. Thank you. Number 4, Isabella Teresa Rieg. Number 3 for the class of 2020, Rebecca Mary Wozniak. Thank you. The salutatorian for the class of 2020, Anna E. Victoria Gutierrez. And number 1, our valedictorian for the class of 2020, Haley Ray Marilyn Peacock. Yeah, should I just read this there? Congratulations to the class of 2020. Just some closing remarks. First, I'd like to recognize two individuals who have been instrumental this year at Platt High School. I'd like to recognize assistant principals Mr. Peter Civitello and Mr. Jeffrey Kenyon. As a high school principal here at Platt, they have been outstanding administrators to our students and a tremendous asset to not only me, but to all of our students at Platt High School. I thank you both for everything you have done for all of our students in achieving their success this year. Thank you. Seniors, 4 years ago, you started a new journey in your life, a journey like no other graduating class at Platt High School has ever experienced. I must say that this journey with all of you over the past 4 years, especially this year, has been one of the most rewarding and fulfilling times of my life. It's certainly not the way we all expected it to end. However, through these very challenging times, you have all worked very hard in earning the seat you are sitting in today. Together, you have forged ahead when others doubted you to experience successes and find happiness in your accomplishments. No one has ever had to experience what you all have had to in the past 3 months. For that alone, you have my utmost respect and admiration for that accomplishment. I recently read a book written by General William McRaven. General McRaven was a 4-star general and had an illustrious 37-year career in the U.S. Navy, most of that serving in the elite Navy SEAL Team 6 and commanding the Joint Special Operations Command. In this book titled, Make Your Bed, he explains how making your bed every morning can have a positive impact on your well-being and behavior throughout the rest of the day. A normal part of the day for the Navy SEAL was from 7:30 a.m. to 9 a.m. They did physical training every single morning for most of their careers as Navy SEALs. That's not an easy thing to do every morning. The cadets also had their beds inspected every morning. If you did it right, the corners would be square, the covers would be pulled tight, the pillow just centered under the headboard, and the extra blanket folded neatly at the end of the bed. It had to be perfect. The idea of making the bed is it's the same sense of discipline. It's the same sense that you're going to get up and do something, but it's an easy task to undertake. It's not just about kind of throwing the covers over the pillow. It's about making your bed right and walking away and going, okay, that's good. That's good. As simple as it sounds, I'm proud of this little task I did. It is the simplicity. It's also the amount of time that it takes to make your bed. It doesn't take an hour to do, and yet you get this sense of accomplishment. So it's good to start off with a simple task that moves you forward for the rest of the day. The point General McRaven was trying to make is this. If you want to change the world, start off by making your bed. If you make your bed every morning, you will have accomplished the first task of the day. It will give you a small sense of pride, and it will encourage you to do another task and another and another. And by the end of the day, that one task completed, you will have turned into many tasks completed. Making your bed will also reinforce the fact that the little things in life matter. If you can't do the little things right, you'll never be able to do the big things right. And if by chance you have a miserable day, you'll come home to a bed that is made, that you made. And a made bed gives you encouragement that tomorrow will be better. This is your time. Take it on. Don't be afraid to lean into the wind. Love the earth and all its natural glories. And most of all, take care of each other. It will require an open mind and an open heart. And that can be your legacy. We're counting on you. So as your principal, I ask one more thing of you before you move on to your next journey. Make your bed every morning. At this time, I ask the graduates of the class of 2020 to please rise. Move your tassels to the left of your caps. You are now considered alumni of Platt High School.
Been a lot of places, I've been all around the world, seen a lot of faces, never knowing where I was on the horizon. Well, I know the sun will be rising back home. Living out of cases, packing up and taking off, made a lot of changes, but not forgetting who I was on the horizon. Rising back home. Don't forget where you belong. Oh, don't forget where you belong. Oh, if you ever feel alone, don't, you were never on your own. And the proof is in this song. For ages, but I got everything I need. I'm flicking through the pages I've written in my memory. I feel like I'm dreaming. Oh, so I know that I'm never leaving. No, I won't go.
Should be.
this song. Never forget it, this song.
Don't forget it.
No, I never forget it.